स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू नागेश करज की ऑर्किड स्कूल चैनल। माई सेल्फ प्रिया टीचर एंड आई एम गोइंग टू टीच साइंस सब्जेक्ट फॉर क्लास 7। सो प्रीवियसली वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ एलिमेंट्री कैनल। सो इन फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ एलिमेंट्री कैनल वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ टीथ। देन अल्सो वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट टंग, व्हाट आर द फंक्शंस ऑफ टंग, एंड देन अल्सो वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट सलाइवरी glands and what are the functions of salivary gland. So in this today's session also we are going to learn more about different or next parts of alimentary canal. Okay, so next part of alimentary canal is a esophagus, or it is also called as a food pipe. So see here, food pipe or esophagus. So after mouth or after chewing food in our mouth, that food is converted into bolus. So bolus, it is only a part of food which is mixed in a saliva. So after mastication, that saliva mixes with food, and that food which is broken down into small particle, it turns into a bolus, and that bolus, it is passed towards the digestive system or next part of this alimentary canal. So what is the next part of alimentary canal? There is a food pipe. So next to mouth or next to buccal cavity, the part is called as a food pipe, or it is also called as a esophagus. So esophagus, the swallowed food passes into the food pipe or esophagus. So food pipe runs along the neck and the chest. So that food pipe, it runs along the neck and also in chest. So the length of this pipe will vary anywhere between 8 to 25 centimeters. So what is the length of this food pipe? Why it is called as a pipe? Because that it is, its structure is like a pipe. That is why. So when I shown you the first picture of digestive system of human, that time I told you that this, the structure of this esophagus is like a pipe. That is why it is also called as a food pipe. So that length of this pipe, it will vary anywhere. So it will vary. So why it is, it can be vary? Because of age also, and the size or height of any person. So depending upon height or growth and development of any person, and also that age of any person, that length of food pipe, it can vary in different person. So what it be? It will be then. So it will between 8 centimeter to 15 centimeter. So it will in between this 8 centimeter to 25 centimeter. So when you are younger, that time it will be 8, 9, 10 centimeter. And when there will be a growth, full growth or and development of yourself, then you will find that your food pipe is 23 centimeter, 24 centimeter, or maybe 25 centimeter in length. Then food is pushed down by movement of the wall of the food pipe. So there is a movement occur here in food pipe. So sometimes it can contract and sometimes it can relax. So this contraction and relaxation of food pipe, it can help to push down that bolus or food, we can say. So that food is pushed by movement of contraction and relaxation of the wall of food pipe. At times the food is not accepted by our stomach and it is vomited out. So sometimes what happens when we are going to push this food into our stomach or into our mouth, so that swallowing food is passing through this esophagus, what happens? Sometimes stomach is not going to allow that food to enter itself or enter in stomach. So because of stomach is not allowing to enter that food, because of that what happens, that food is going to reverse or come back, and what happens, so vomiting can happens here. So sometimes when you eat, next point, sometimes when you eat in hurry, talk or laugh while eating, you may cough, get hiccups or choking sensation. So not only because of stomach is not allowing, we can omit or vomiting occurs there, but also sometimes what happens when you eat in hurry. So when you will eat in hurry and also while eating you are talking at that time, and also when you are laughing while you are having or you while you are eating something, that time also you may cough, get hiccups or a choking sensation. This happens when food particles enter the windpipe. Here a picture is shown here. In this picture you can see this is a buccal cavity, and that mastication process, after that mastication process, that food is going to enter this esophagus. So here this pink colored structure is nothing but esophagus, and this blue colored structure, it is a trachea. So what it means, trachea? Now only we read here, this happens when food particles enter the windpipe. So whenever we are going to eat in hurry, whenever we are going to eat while we are talking, whenever we are going to eat while we are laughing, that time when cough is causes cough, hiccups or choking sensation, because that food is entered in a windpipe. So this is nothing but a windpipe. So this food pipe and esophagus, they are adjacent to each other. So the windpipe carries air from nostrils to the lungs. So this is a structure of nostril. So from these nostrils, these windpipes are going to carry air and they are passing it towards the lungs, okay, and there this air is going to be oxygenated. So this windpipe and this esophagus, so these two pipes, food pipe we can say and windpipe we can say. So food pipe is carrying food and windpipe is carrying air. So both these pipes are adjacent to each other. They are located near to each other, or we can say adjustable position. So, but inside the throat, air and food pipe share a common passage. So when they are adjacent to each other, what is the structure of this windpipe and food pipe? So inside throat, so here is the structure of throat. So when these two pipes entering into the throat, these two both pipes are going to enter in a same place or in a same passage here given, okay, same passage, and then same passage, it is called as a pharynx. See, this structure is given here, pharynx. So in this pharynx, these both windpipe and food pipe both are going to enter in this same structure, which is called as a pharynx. So this is a common passage. So this common passage is named as a pharynx. So you have to know that when there is a food in a food pipe and wind in a wind pipe, so why they are not going to mix here in pharynx? So they are not going to mix here because during the act of swallowing, a flap like valve closes, okay. When that food is swallowed here from mouth to the esophagus, there is a flap here, okay, flap like valve here. Valve, it means it is a flat muscular structure which is not going to or it is a lead like structure, okay, but which is a muscular structure. That muscular lead like structure or flap like structure is going to closes the passage of windpipe. It means when food is going to enter here in pharynx or at that in that common passage, that wall is going to close windpipe and food can go easily to the esophagus and guides the food into the food pipe. So because of that closing pharynx windpipe, by this wall food can go further or food can go into food pipe easily. And while there is no swallowing of food, that wall can open for allow to enter air which is passed from nostril or from our nose, okay. So because of that walls, food and air cannot be mixed here in pharynx or in a common passage. But what happens when you are going to laugh while you are eating or when you are going to have food in hurry, or also when you are going to have food while you are talking or laughing, that time suppose it will not get time to close and open. So that wall is not closed properly. You are laughing or you are talking, and at that time if suppose you are going to swallow your food into your mouth in hurry, then this valve is not closed properly, so that food particles can enter into pharynx or into windpipe, and because of that, that it is not windpipe is not going to allow that food to enter in trachea. So it will be harmful to our lungs also, and it can cause death also. So while you are having food, you have to remember that do not laugh, do not talk, and also do not have your food while you are in hurry. Okay, so these instructions are also given by your parents to you, and also this instruction you heard by your from your teachers also. But some students can listen, or some students listen this properly, but some students sometimes not taking it as a seriously, okay. So you have to take it serious, you have to have food very, you have to be calm when you are going to have any type of food, okay. The next part, it is a stomach. So after esophagus, because of contraction and relaxation or the movement in esophagus, that bolus is going to here. The yellow colored structure is nothing but the bolus. That bolus, it means the very tiny particles of food here. So that food or bolus from this esophagus is going towards the stomach. So next part, it is a stomach here. The stomach is a thick walled bag. So wall of this stomach, it is very thick, okay. And in stomach, majority of digestion occurs assisted by liver and pancreas. So this is only a part of digestive system, or we can say of alimentary canal. Stomach is the main part where that majority of digestion of food occurs, and these glands. So in mouth, salivary glands are there which are helping in digestion to buccal cavity, okay. And here there are some glands which are called as a liver and pancreas. So these two glands are going to help stomach to digest whatever food is going to come in this stomach, okay. Then the inner lining of the stomach secretes mucus, hydrochloric acid and digestive juices. So this is the internal structure shown here. So this internal structure or inner lining of this stomach, these are going to secrete mucus. Mucus is a substance which can kill bacteria, okay. So that is the substance. So the stomach is going to, inner lining of stomach is going to secrete mucus, then hydrochloric acid. So you know HCl. So I told you HCl is a very harmful substance or molecule or liquid which can cause any type of damage to our skin. Okay, so but here in our stomach HCl is present, but it is not going to harm that stomach and also our body. Okay, it is in a proper amount, it is there present in stomach. And also some types of digestive juices are there which are secreted by stomach. So all these substances, what they are going to do here? So the acid kills many bacteria. So thus the hydrochloric acid, okay, the hydrochloric acid which is secreted by stomach, it kills many bacteria, okay, and that enter along with the food. So this HCl is going to kill different types of bacteria which entered with the food which we taken in our mouth. And the acid also makes the medium in the stomach acidic. Okay, so whenever there is a digestion of food occurs here, there is a some type of medium is here, that acid is going to make this medium acidic and helps the digestive juices to act. So the because of that medium becomes acidic, the digestive juices can act and they can digest food easily. And then digestive juices break down the proteins. So whatever different types of nutrients are entering with this food, okay, so from that these digestive juices, what they are going to do? So they are going to break down the proteins into simple substances. So one more time I am going to tell you that from esophagus food is going to enter in this stomach, and inner lining of this stomach they are going to secrete HCl, then mucus and digestive juices. Mucus and HCl are going to kill bacteria here which are entered with food and which are harmful also. So these two secretions are going to kill them, and after that HCl is again going to make a medium acidic, and because of that digestive juices can act and they can break down proteins. Whatever proteins are there present in food, that proteins are going to converted into simple substances. So this is the structure of stomach of human being and a part of alimentary canal where this type of digestion occurs here. And to stomach there are two glands are helping for digestion. Which one? First one, it is a liver, and second one, it is a pancreas. So let us know about next part of this alimentary canal. After stomach there is a next part, it is a small intestine. So it is called as a small intestine. In this picture you can see here, see this structure is called as a small intestine. So here you can see stomach, so this is a mouth or buccal cavity. Then here this is a esophagus here, or a food pipe here, and this structure is nothing but the windpipe, and here this structure it is a pharynx, and this is called as a trachea. So windpipe, when it is going towards the lungs, it is called as a trachea here. So we are going to see that after esophagus food enters into stomach, and then from this stomach after digestion food is going to enter. This is a small structure or initial part of small intestine. It is called as a duodenum. It is called as a duodenum. So it is nothing but the initial part of small intestine. And then here you can see the structure of small intestine. So this small intestine is highly coiled here. So it is not cooled, it is a mistake, spelling mistake is here. So highly coiled, and is about 7.5 meters long. So see, this is a structure of 7.5 meter in length, and it receives secretory from the liver and the pancreas. It means there are some secretions which are secreted by liver and pancreas. So small intestine is also going to receive secretions from liver and pancreas. Then the liver is reddish brown gland. So next part, it is a liver. Here you can see liver. So liver is a reddish brown gland. It is largest gland in the body. So that gland which is helping to small intestine and to stomach with their secretion, that is a largest gland in our body, and it is reddish brown in color, okay? And then it secretes bile juice. So that secretion which is secreted by liver, it is called as a bile juice, that is stored in a sac called gallbladder. Again, here is a spelling mistake. It is a gallbladder. Here you can see the structure of gallbladder near to liver. Also, you can see in your textbook, if you will not understood these words, okay, there are some spelling mistakes, you can check it in your textbook, from your textbook. So the secretion which is secreted by liver, it is called as a bile juice, and it is stored in a gallbladder. So bile helps to digest fats. So what is the function of this bile or this secretion? Bile can helps to digest fats. So some types of fats are also entered in our body with the food, and that fats are going to digest by this bile. Then next part, it is a pancreas. So pancreas, it is here, you can see the below the stomach. So pancreas is a large cream colored. Here you can see cream colored, large, and pancreas is a gland. So it is a large cream colored gland located just below the stomach. Here just below the stomach you can see a cream colored and a large gland which is known as pancreas. The pancreatic juice acts on the carbohydrates, fats and proteins. So these pancreatic juice are going to digest carbohydrates also, fats also, and proteins also. It means this pancreatic juice is going to break down carbohydrates, fats and proteins into simpler substances. Then the carbohydrates get broken into the simple sugars such as glucose, fats into fatty acids, and glycerol and proteins into the amino acids. While pancreatic juice is going to act on these three types of nutrients, we can see here carbohydrates, fats and proteins. What happens? These carbohydrates are going to break down into simple sugar, and that sugar may be, it is called as a glucose, lactose, okay? These types of simple sugars are there. Then fats are going to break down into fatty acids and glycerol. So these are the simpler substances. From fats, which simpler substances are going to converted? Fatty acids and glycerol. And from proteins, proteins are going to break down into amino acids. Okay? So these amino acids are nothing but the simpler form of protein. So in short, we discussed about the next part of alimentary canal, which is known as, first part we discussed esophagus, then stomach, then small intestine. So here, see, the digested food can now pass into the blood vessels. So what happens here? See, here we saw structure of small intestine, and what happens here in small intestine. So we learned that liver, pancreas, and how that liver and pancreas are going to make this or break down these complex substances into simple substances. And after that, what happens here? The digested food. So it means after conversion of complex substances into simple substances, it means that food is got digested now. So we can say that the digested food. So the digested food can now pass into the blood vessels. Okay, so which blood vessels? So blood vessels in the wall of small intestine. So this digested food can enter into the blood vessels which are located there inner lining or inner wall of small intestine. The process is called absorption. So this this passing of this digested food into blood vessels of small intestine, that process is called as a absorption. It means digested food, from this digested food whatever molecules or whatever particles are useful to our body, they are going to absorbed by this small intestine. So small intestine is going to absorb all these nutrients or all these simple substances from that digested food, and this process is called as a absorption. The inner wall of intestine, inner wall of small intestine, have thousands of finger like outgrowths called villi. Okay, so there are structure which is a finger like structure or a finger like outgrowth is there in small intestine, and it is called as a villi. Are the plural form and villus is the singular form. So they are present in thousands of number. Okay, then next part, it is a large intestine. Here you can see the structure of large intestine around the small intestine. Okay, so the large intestine is wider and shorter than the small intestine. It is also wider, but it is not longer than small intestine. Though it is called as a large intestine, but it is called because of its width. Okay, so large intestine, it's called large intestine because of its width, but it is not longer than small intestine, but it is shorter in size and it is about 1.5 meter in length. So we saw small intestine is 7.5 meters in a length, but large intestine, it is a 1.5 meter in length. Its function is to absorb water and some salts from the undigested food. So what is the function of large intestine? So large intestine is going to absorb water and some salts from the undigested food material. So whatever undigested food is remained there in our body after digestion, that food is going to be passed into large intestine, and from that undigested food, large intestine is again going to absorb water and some types of salts, and then only after absorption of water and salt, whatever wasted part is there or whatever undigested part is there, that is called as a fecal matter, and that fecal matter is not at all useful to our body, and the fecal matter is removed through the anus from time to time. This is called as a ejection. So whatever undigested food comes to the large intestine is going to absorb water and salts from that, and that remaining part, it is called as a fecal. That fecal matter have to throughout from our body time to time, because if it will remain in our body, it will cause different types of diseases or any type of disease can be caused because of that remaining of that fecal material in our body. So that process of throwing this fecal matter through the anus, it is called as a ejection. Okay, so we discussed all parts of alimentary canal here. So first part we discussed, it is a mouth and buccal cavity. Then second part also we discussed here, which is a esophagus. Third part we discussed, which is a stomach. In stomach we discussed that stomach is going to digest food with the help of liver and pancreas. Again, that digested food is going to pass to small intestine, and in small intestine with the help of liver and pancreas again. Small intestine is going to again digest food and also absorb different types of useful particles or nutrients, we can say, from that small intestine, and whatever remaining part is there or whatever undigested food is there, that is going to pass to the large intestine, and large intestine is going to absorb water, salts, and then whatever material is remaining there, that is called as a fecal matter, and that fecal matter is thrown out from through the anus. Okay, so all these parts we learned here, we discussed here, and how they are going to work, I will show you a video, a very nice video, for to show how that food is going to enter in our mouth and how, what type of digestion process, or what are the that video will show you how that all parts are going to perform a digestion process on that food. Okay, that I will show you in our next session. Till now we will stop here, and thank you.